I'm from a small town, Floyd, Virginia. Born and raised there, one stoplight town. More cows than people, pretty much. I spent a lot of time growing up going to the Floyd Country Store. It's a big tourist attraction there. So that was really my first introduction to live music. Spent a lot of Friday nights falling asleep on my grandpa's lap, listening to bluegrass music. That kind of led to me picking up the fiddle, which is what I thought I was going to be playing, and I stepped into lessons, which ended up being classical Suzuki, which I hated. And my grandmother bought me a guitar, and that's when I started playing and writing songs. As a kid, I mean, I would like to say I was quiet, but at the same time, I was not quiet. But I always did feel like there were parts of me that I kept pretty hidden, obviously, the music. From an early age, being told my voice was weird. You know, we grew up listening to Shania Twain and Faith Hill, and they had these crystal clear voices, and then mine had this bit of gravel to it that was a little different than what any of us kids running around were used to listening to, so I guess it makes sense. But I was always okay with my voice because I continued to write and to sing for myself, and so I think that that's what helps me be as authentic today with my music that I am. I think it was about 7 when I wrote my first song. I think it was just something that I just gravitated towards. It was just something that I did, something I enjoyed. And, you know, I can't really remember a pivotal moment when I sat down and wrote something. It was just always something that I did. You know, some people journal, but I wrote songs. All of my songs are real life, whether they've happened to me or someone I know or someone I've watched. I try to write about authentic things. There's only so many things I, myself, can experience. So as long as I can take from something real that someone else around me has had happen to them, you know, I feel I've done my job as a songwriter. I look back at wilder days that I wrote and I wonder why I had to experience some of the things I experienced to write that and realize it's what got me here. It's kind of harder to feel in that moment. Sometimes even when writing that song, I don't understand it, but looking back later, I get why things happened the way they did to put me in that moment. Signing with Sony was obviously a huge deal. You know, I look back at the kid that I was, wondering if I was good enough to do anything. And here I am, you know, 26 years old, signed to a major label with all these amazing artists here, and met Randy and started talking to him and really was like, okay, this guy really actually listened to my record. He actually knows these lyrics and he's interested. And I really just started to think for myself and be like, I feel like this is a good move. I feel like these are people that believe in me and they have the resources to really help me push my record and get out there and do more than what I could ever do on an indie label. When I met Randy, I thought to myself, I have to have one little like weird demand. And I was like, you need to get me a dog. I want a French Bulldog, and if you get me a French Bulldog, I'll name Sony after the label. So he got me a French Bulldog, and his name is Sony. And he's way cooler than I'll ever be. You say you hate the smell of cigarette smoke. Wilder Days is a song that I think a lot of us can really connect with and feel. I think that maybe we've all had that one person that we feel got away. Right person, wrong timing. And if we would have met just a few years earlier, it really would have worked out and we would have been on the same level and we would have either really had a good thing or made a really big mess, but it would have really worked out. It just didn't happen to go that way. If I was to take anything away from it, it would just be not to lose that wilder side of yourself and to, you know, not conform and just to stay true and just do the things you want to freaking do because you get one life. I wouldn't say I'm brave. Am I crazy? Absolutely. You can listen to the records and tell that. But I think just being honest and being real and genuine is the only way I know how to write. I mean, if I listened to everything that everyone ever told me to do, I wouldn't be where I'm at. So if reckless is not obeying the rules and reckless is making your own path, then I think it's a great thing. And I think it was the perfect title for this record. So when you do the things that I've done, you appear reckless. But if that's how they want to perceive living, I'm okay with that. I don't know what the future holds and how long this will be, but all I know is I want all of it. Everything I can get, everything I can do, I want to do it.